A few nights ago, I taught my Python students how to write a loop to see how many times I needed to fold a piece of paper to make a paper stack the height of the Burj Khalifa, which is 830 meters tall. Assuming that our piece of paper was 0.1 millimeters thick, we had some early guesses, maybe 100,000 folds or a million folds, but this is the program that I wrote. You can download it in the link in the description. We have a stack height starting at 0.0001 meters, which is 0.1 millimeters, and that the target height is 830 meters. While the stack height is less than the target height, we fold the piece of paper, therefore doubling the stack height and incrementing the number of folds. And our final answer is 23 folds. G'day, I'm Mr. Code. So where is the error in my code? Well, the answer is there isn't any error. This is the power of exponential growth, and I'll prove it to you right now. On our first fold, we are doubling the thickness of our 0.1 millimeter thick piece of paper to become 0.2 millimeters thick, or about the same height as the print nozzle of a 3D printer. On the second fold, we are at 0.4 millimeters thick, which is about the width of the 3D extruder nozzle. Fold 3 takes us to 0.8 millimeters, which is about the thickness of a vaccination needle, and fold 4 makes our stack of paper barely thicker than the nib of a felt tip pen. Now you're sitting there thinking, Mr. Code, this is taking ages. How will you ever get to 830 meters, the height of the world's tallest building? To which I would say, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. And this paper folding party is only just getting started. At fold 5, we are over 3 millimeters higher, which is the size of the smallest piece of space debris that can be tracked with a ground-based radar. Fold 6 increases our paper stack to 6.4 millimeters, which is about the thickness of a bone screw that aids in healing a fracture. We break the centimeter barrier with fold 7, which is about the width of the largest vein in the human body, the inferior vena cava. This is also the maximum number of times you can fold an A4 piece of paper. Don't believe me? Pause the video and give it a try yourself. Our paper doubles in size to 2.5 centimeters with fold 8, or about 1 inch for my American friends, which is about the thickness of the world's largest pancake. The next fold brings our oversized piece of paper to a stack over 5 centimeters high, which is the length of an average Australian spider. I'm only joking. Australian spiders are much, much bigger than that. At our 10th fold, our piece of paper is now about the height of the world's smallest satellite. Fold 11 now takes our piece of paper to a stack 20 centimeters high, or the length of the world's longest eyelashes. Fold 12 brings your stack to 40 centimeters high, which is around the size of Compsognathus, the smallest known dinosaur. 12 folds is also the world record for the largest number of paper folds, set by Brittany Gallivan in 2002, using over a kilometer of toilet paper. You're gonna need some heavy machinery to help you make fold 13, which takes your stack to a respectable height of 80 centimeters, about the height of a hurdle. On your 14th fold, you barely recognize your piece of paper anymore because now it is 1.6 meters tall, or the height of an average adult. Fold 15 is where you begin to think this paper folding business is getting out of hand because the stack is now 3.2 meters high, or about the distance separating you from your upstairs neighbor as you scream at each other about this massive paper stack growing in the middle of the street. It's for science, you explain. I'll recycle everything afterwards. Have you subscribed to my channel yet? Fold 16 doubles the stack height to 6.5 meters, and your neighbor calls the police because it's now higher than the pole vaulting world record. It's time to buckle up because this exponential growth rocket is about to take off. Nobody ever thought this would happen, but you fold your piece of paper 17 times, which brings your stack to 13 meters high, or the length of a shipping container. At 18 folds, your stack of paper is now 26 meters high, and it consumes most of the trees in your neighborhood. An adult blue whale is not impressed with you wasting so much paper, but it is surprised that the height of your paper stack is about the same as her length. Fold 19 brings your stack to 52 meters, which is taller than an Olympic swimming pool is long. 20 folds brings your stack to 104 meters tall, which is the height of the HSBC Centre in Brisbane, Australia. 21 folds doubles that to 209 meters tall, about the height of the Aurora Tower. 22 folds makes your paper stack double that to the size of the International Finance Center at Hong Kong. And finally, on the 23rd fold, your paper stack reaches 838 meters, just slightly taller than the world's tallest building. And all of this makes you wonder, why is it that exponential growth is so unintuitive? Why is it that our initial guesses are so far off the mark? Well, one reason is because people struggle to understand exponential growth. Imagine that I have a petri dish about the size of my palm, where I'm going to start cultivating some bacteria. I put some nutrients in and I put in a specimen of bacteria which doubles itself every single minute. This is exponential growth. I calculate the time it takes for the petri dish to be completely full of bacteria will be at 10 a.m. And when will the petri dish be half full? Well, the answer is just 1 minute before 10 o'clock. In fact, just 3 minutes before 10 a.m., the petri dish is only 12.5% full, with the bacteria inside thriving, starting families and thinking, what a wonderful time to be alive, not knowing that in 3 minutes' time, they will run out of food and space and everything will stop. Feel free to download and run my program to see how many paper folds it takes to make a journey higher or further than the Burj Khalifa. And don't forget to post your results in the comment section below. Thanks very much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.